Hello there, everybody. Tim Lazell here, and welcome to the Slice Shed, otherwise known as the carport next to my house. But more importantly, welcome to the first episode of a series I'm going to do called Slice Life. And the purpose of this series is to talk about some of these old school slicey boats and also some of the new ones as well, and give a little bit of the background, the history on these boats, how they paddle, and what we like about them, and why we love slicey kayaking so much. So, a little background on myself is I'm an avid intermediate kayaker. I love play boating, love slicey kayaking, and I just couldn't find enough information on some of these old boats. So, over the last couple years, I've been collecting them and trying to find as many of them as I can to test them out on the river and pass some of that information on to you. So, we're going to just have some fun. We're going to talk about old boats and show some river footage. And at the end of each episode, there's going to be something that I thought about. It's going to involve actually what's in this plastic bag right here. I think it's a cool idea. Some of you might think it's dumb, but you got to hang out to the end of the episode to see what happens and what in the world's in this plastic bag. So, Slice Life. Let's go. On our first episode, we're going to take a look at one of the classics, one of the early boats. Nope, it is not this Savage Lynx here. Some of you guys have probably heard about this boat, one of the rarest, actually probably the rarest slicey kayak ever produced. Only about 12 of them ever made. We got the Zip. We've got the Prion Delirious. I can't wait to take this down the river. I've actually not gone down river with it yet, so really looking forward to that one. We got the Ego, Triple X, Amp, Lucid, Ultrafuge. We've got the Slick Stick, Blitz Special, Foreplay, Big Easy. The Session, not Session Plus, that's gotta be one of my favorites here. Prozone, but today, we're taking out the Mr. Clean. So, the Mr. Clean, that's the boat of the week. Also known as the bucket on a surfboard. And you can see why it got that nickname with the really intense reduction of volume in the bow and the stern. And that was something that I always was intrigued by. I really like it when a slicey kayak is extreme, right? You know, not a real slow reduction of volume, not too much going on in here. I like to have, you know, some room for my knees and, you know, no room for my feet, really cramming them in there. But so this boat came out in 1999, which puts it really as some of the first slicey kayaks that were coming out. The predecessor to this would have been maybe the 3D, Perception 3D in 98. But they were making boats much shorter, actually thinning out the ends and figuring out how to do the slicey moves that were all the rage in rodeo kayaking at the time. So we're looking at, I believe the specs on this are 7'9" by 25 inches and right at about 54 gallons of volume, designed by Shane Benedict, owner of Liquid Logic Kayaks now. So let's go take this on the river and give it a paddle and come back here and talk about
I told you.
The Mr. Clean.
I'm gonna float like a butterfly and sting like a bee.
I'm not your enemy from where I stand. Hard knocks, no sympathy. The homemade man. Faster than the Argosy, this boat of alarm will be floating. Say, without a doubt about my way. No way around it, be eye to eye, and then you to knock me. Then you to knock me.
Well, that was a lap on the Washougal River, the Mr. Clean. And as you can see, I've got it sitting up here next to the home slice. And so I want to talk about a few of the things I liked and didn't like about the Mr. Clean. So again, this is kind of an early slice boat. And I could tell some of that in the way it was behaving on the river. It was doing things I didn't necessarily want it to do. It wasn't as smooth. It wasn't as clean as, say, the home slice. And what you're looking at here, obviously, is a huge time difference between these two designs, but the same designer and in Shane Benedict. And so you can tell that as you look at the boat, each boat, they've got similar styles, but what I was really hoping for in the Mr. Clean is these really slicey ends and the room for my knees here. And what I ended up getting is just the bucket on a surfboard. There's too much bucket. Like, I like something that's really slicey. I like to be able to throw the bow down really easily. And on pretty much any of these slicey kayaks, getting the tail down is not difficult. But in this case, you know, all of this volume that we end up getting here in the bow, does definitely make it harder to do cartwheels in. So, you know, some people absolutely love this boat. I found it to be a little bit cumbersome, a little bit unpredictable. We weren't speaking the same language. Now we're getting on to the final part of this episode here, and that is what I've got going on in here. If you've followed Slicey Kayaks at all, one of the things that people always argue about is the volume. There's stories saying that the volumes are completely inaccurate and that, you know, you can't trust them at all. So I got a water meter. And what I'm going to do with each of these boats is, after I paddle them, hook them up to the hose, and we're going to actually pour water in them and measure how many gallons they take. Now, I know what you're going to think. You're going to say, hey, they got the outfitting in them. Are you going to take all the outfitting out? What are you going to do? Well, no, I'm not going to take the outfitting out because I am not that ambitious. But we're going to have a apples to apples comparison from one boat to another. So if we look at the Mr. Clean versus like the Ultra Clean right here, the Ultra Clean, I think on paper, has like 1 gallon more of volume. And if we do, tonight we're actually going to do the test for both of them. And if we put 5 more gallons of water in here than we do in the Mr. Clean, then it's like, that's a definitive proof that the volumes aren't accurate. We're gonna set this up, set up the water, and crack a cold beverage, and watch this boat fill up.
All right, here we go.
Five gallons so far. Alright, we're up to 18 gallons in here. So I just looked up the specs on my phone, refreshed myself. 54 gallons apparently, according to the old 2000 Perception catalog. 54 gallons in Mr. Clean, 55 gallons in the Ultra Clean, and I call bogus on that. Here. Close to that rim, 37 gallons. Got a little ways to go. I'm not going to be able to fill in all of that area. And then there's also the bump in the back here. I don't think I'm going to be able to get that. Okay, here it is. We just spilled over the edge there. Yes, I did not get in that area of the cockpit. And we are looking at 40.8 gallons in the Mr. Clean. So, what does that mean? Really, it means absolutely nothing until we compare it to the Ultra Clean. Okay, we just finished filling the Ultra Clean, and it looks like we have 44.4 gallons on the gauge. And so you can see both of them completely filled up. So we're looking at almost 4 gallons more in the Ultra Clean versus the Mr. Clean. Could some of that be attributed to outfitting? Outfitting actually looks a little bit more robust in the Ultra Clean, a little bit more involved. So if anything, there would be less volume. So are volumes on the paper in these old school boats completely worthless? Maybe. We'll continue testing boats. And we'll do the little fill test at the end of every episode. So stay tuned for the next one. And thank you for joining me and enjoying the review of the Mr. Clean.